everybody, welcome back to Gaijin Bang's channel. Today we'll be talking about something very near and dear to our hearts, which is sports. And what kind of sports, you ask? I think soccer. Soccer is the second most famous sport other than baseball in Japan. Japan is the second most prestigious soccer team in Asia. It is called the J-League. And they are just gaining more and more popularity after every World Cup, every pre-qualification game. Their popularity is rising. So it is a very big sport here in Japan. Japan hosted the World Cup joint with South Korea in 2002. And then just this last year, 2008, we all saw it. Japan lost at the last minute to Belgium. We were very bummed. But I still remember the streets of Japan. They were just screaming in despair. And whenever we would score, they would just be like, just shouting outside the door. So it is becoming a huge thing here. We made a buzz after Japan lost the World Cup. They cleaned the cloakroom just squeaky clean. And everyone was really, really impressed by the Japanese culture in that sense, where even if they lost, they left everything spotless and kept it respectful. A really famous, well-known anime called Captain Tsubasa is really known for their long sequence runs. So, you know, it'll be like 20 minutes of him making the run, but he's like thinking the whole time in his head. So the whole episode has gone by. You don't really see much action, but you just listen to everything that he's thinking, which has made a great impact in the anime world and very well known for that. A whole generation grew up with the golden ages of what we call PES, Pro Evolution Soccer. That's what they would call it in Europe. In Japan, they call it Winning 11. It's a really famous soccer game. A lot of people are familiar with it as they played it from way back when to now in the arcades. So a downside to being a huge soccer fan, foreigner here in Japan, is a lot of the European and foreign games are aired at a really horrible time. It's like at 5 a.m. and on a weekday, so you know you have to lose some sleep before you go to work because you gotta catch the game. But you know, that doesn't stop you from staying out late and having fun, since there are a lot of bars that are open late playing these games. So you and your foreigner buddy can go and lose sleep together. You can look up a lot of bars in the Tokyo area that have those channels. Some of these bars may even have fun games like foosball. Japanese love to play darts and billiards. So make some friends, watch the game together, and mingle. So the major soccer stadium here in Tokyo actually got demolished in 2015 and is being rebuilt and will be reopened on 2019, unfortunately not in time for the rugby games, but in time for the Olympics. So in conclusion, soccer is a rapidly growing sport. Japan is getting better and better in the Asian, you know, region. It's such a fun sport to watch when Japan is playing because, like I said, everyone in the streets is just like, they can't sit down. They're so excited and they're screaming. So it's kind of reminds me of like American football or, you know, basketball when you're in like a popular basketball area. So just get out there. Like I said, make some friends. There are a lot of guys especially, but not only guys, women too. So that's just one way to mingle. One way to mingle is over sports, which is international. Isn't that beautiful? All right, everybody. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.